marriage and sex journey into unknown dimensions. One day you are born as an interaction between ovum and sperm. The sperm represents the masculine energy and ovum represents the feminine energy. The birth always happens as the interaction between these two aspects of the cosmic energy. And then your life of conflict, duality continues. And one day suddenly the life energy is released once again from the sex center into the unknown oblivion. Death happens. One day you are born out of sexual interaction, and again one day you attain to death through the same center without any flowering of your being. Very rarely the journey of transcendence beyond sex begins in an individual. Through sex you are born one day, through sex center one day you will disappear. And by understanding the flow of this existential energy, one day you are reborn. Every religion speaks of reborn, whether it is Christianity, Hinduism or Islam. What is this twice born or reborn means? It means your journey that was continuing downward as an embodiment of ovum and sperm changes its direction. When you are guided by the ovum and sperm, you are bound by the gravitational force of Earth. It pulls you down. Just as gravitational force pulls everything downwards, so too it pulls you down towards lower instincts, and out of that lower emotions or nafs continues to grow. As the journey begins, this force that was a gravitational force changes its direction, and instead of gravitational force, it becomes the force of grace. The upward movement begins, and with that, you are in the process of being reborn. Going through the sexual intercourse meditatively, when masculine and feminine energies move in harmony and rhythm, you get the first glimpse of Satori, the orgasmic experience of dissolution of two energies. During such moments, when two energies merge into one another, the couple experiences a fleeting glimpse of a state beyond time and space. In that orgasmic experience, timelessness happens and you disappear into the unknown. Out of such an experience of inner oneness, sage Vatsayana's classic treatise of Kama Sutra emerged as the sutras of Kama, the principles and techniques for the transformation of this existential bioenergy. And when this energy is transformed, the flowering of consciousness as enlightenment takes place. Out of this understanding, Tilopa's Mahamudra and Songs of Saraha and the supreme understanding of Tantra emerged. To augment this, the Vigyan Bhairav Tantra, first treatise on meditation, came into existence nearly 5,000 years ago. And in this treatise, Devi, the consort of Shiva, inquires certain questions, and in response to each question, Shiva gives a meditation technique. The sex is the dimension of spirituality beyond the realm of know. Sex is most spontaneous and natural energy, mocked, disfigured, blamed, and continuously criticized by the society, power, and the religious custodians. To understand sex, you have to go to the dimension beyond the know. Breathing and meditation are the vehicles to take you to that unknown and unknowable realm. When sex is understood, this indomitable energy will transform, and in the process, life will become a marvelous journey of spirit. However, in the absence, life will remain a mystery. All is too little that the world can give, because its power and knowledge are the gifts of time. These cannot fill the spirit's sacred thirst. The world and its affairs cannot bring into life's closed room the immortal's air and fill finite with the infinite. All that denies this must be torn out and slain and crushed. The many longings for whose sake we lose the one for whom our lives were made. Sex is the manifestation of the existential bioenergy at the lowest rung. At the lowest rung, the energy represents the earth element. Alike earth, the other elemental element, water and fire, are also relevant. It is only when these three elements are saturated, journey reaches the realm of emotions. The three realms are earth, water and fire. Then it reaches the realm of emotions. Lower has to be sanctified. Only then the energy gives rise to the positive elements. And finally the energy connects to the sky elements. When earth and sky elements are merged into one another, for the first time you experience love. Love is the ultimate loving of this existential energy. First, love gives you unity in your innermost core. Then you are no more a body, no more a mind, no more a soul. You are beyond. You are simply one, unnamed, undefined, unclassified, no more determinate, definable, no more comprehensible. Then a mystery, a joy, a surprise, and a great celebration begins. The soul's experiment of joy and grief and thought and impulse, lighting and blind acts, venture on the roots of the circumference. All that happens on the circumference, through inner movement and external scenes, traveling to self across the forms of things, into creation's center, he had come into existence. This spirit, wandering from state to state, finds here the silence of its starting point, beginning in the formless force and the still fixity. Both sex and spirituality may look to be different and separate from one another, but essentially they are interconnected to one another. Perceptions may differ, but intrinsically they are not opposites, they are not antagonistic, they are not in conflict with one another, rather they are part of a continuum. While sex is basically the universal life energy, a creative, a healing energy, or simply creativity, spirituality on the other hand is a miraculous alchemy. It is the ultimate manifestation of transformation. Seeing this clearly is necessary for us to make it easier to explore briefly the mysteries of sex and spirituality. Sex is not created or manufactured by us. It is actually a gift from the divine. It is God's gift to enjoy, celebrate, and ultimately transform, so that one day you can go beyond this. And yet almost universally we apply double standards in accepting it as a given reality. We show untrue and hypocritical and rather schizophrenic attitude towards sex. Next to God, sex is the most widely misunderstood subject. And if I were to replace the word God with spirituality, then next to spirituality, sex is the most misused term. Sages have seen sex as a spiritual and spirituality as the sublime form of sex energy. It is seen as orgasmic union, enlightenment and dissolving of male-female yin and yang polarity. The transformation of this creative energy into spirituality can be accomplished through a miraculous alchemy of meditation. Indeed, six is the energy. This I keep on emphasizing again and again so that it becomes a part of your understanding. So I will not say sex energy because there is no other energy. Sex is the only energy that you have got. This is the existential bioenergy that you come into world of manifestation. This energy can be transformed at this stage of its manifestation. It is baser. However, when transformed, it can become the higher energy. The higher it moves, the less and less sexuality remains in it. Sexuality means you are governed by the gravitational force that keeps you pulling down. In its baser form, sex pulls you down, and that is what the direction has to change. When a spaceship is trying to enter into another planet or another realm, it has to gather tremendous force because it is going beyond the gravitational force of Earth, the downward movement. And when it reaches to the very end, where the gravitational force of Earth is coming to an end and it is entering into the gravitational pull of the other planet or other realm, tremendous forces needed to plunder into that. Unless and until it comes out of the gravitational force of the Earth, the gravitational pull of the other planet does not work. That is why when you are moving from nafs to kalb, tremendous effort is needed, effort in the form of understanding, austerities and meditation. The trinity that Sufis use, zikr, fikr, marhaba. Zikr in a deeper aspect is moment-to-moment awareness of that which is. And zikr is the way to attain to that awareness, that every moment you are aware of the presence of the subtle, aware of the presence of the divine in you. So higher it moves, the less and less sexuality remains in it, and there is an end, peak where it becomes simply love and compassion. The ultimate flowering we can call as divine energy, but the base, the seed, remains the sex. Coal and diamond grow simultaneously under the earth. Coal is the amorphous form of the diamond, and diamond is the hardest metal known. The more pressure of the earth remains on the diamond, both organic compound of carbon into various combinations. Diamond is an expensive metal and coal is not. It takes a long time and a great pressure of the earth for the coal to transform into diamond. In the same way, it takes long for the baser energies to transform into love and compassion. Effort is needed. The ultimate flowering we can call divine energy, but the base, the seed, remains sex. So sex is the first bottom layer of the energy and God is the top layer, but the same energy moves. Or we can say sex is the lowest rung of the layer of the ladder that takes you to the sunlit peak of your consciousness, and God is the highest round or the layer of this energy. Below sex there is darkness of ignorance and other attributes of the mind. However, beyond God there is sunlit peak of consciousness or the state of super consciousness, and at that peak there is awareness, suchness, perennial bliss, harmony and oneness. To attain to this, to enter into a male-female relation, marriage was devised as an instrument so that the two people, two energies, can live together and experience this. Marriage is the highest climax or peak of love. Verily, it has nothing religious in it. It is a device to enter into a methodology. To give it a religious sanction is the conspiracy of the vested interest. There is tremendous desire and longing for love in man, but love needs great awareness. Only then it can reach its highest peak, the climax. And that highest climax when love blossoms is marriage. It has nothing to do with law. It is the merging. Marriage is the merging of two hearts into totality. It is the functioning of two persons in synchronicity and harmony. Know this happening as marriage. And in that, the consciousness, the awareness that Master represents comes like pole star that radiates tremendous pull. Those who are vulnerable and ready start feeling it within and start moving towards this pole. You may be thousands and thousands of miles apart from this pole star, yet still its pull creates a parallel pole in you. And beyond your will, you are constantly pulled as if an invisible strong current is pulling you, and like the helpless one, you are pulled towards it. I have heard that one day Mullah Nasruddin was, this is the situation of each one of us. I have heard one day Mullah Nasruddin was celebrating his 25th wedding anniversary. So he wrote a letter to his wife. This is the story of each one of you. Introspect on the words before we go into it. My dear Mrs. Nasruddin, today is the 25th wedding anniversary. This day, therefore, I wish to remind you of our love life and commitments together. In the past 1 year, I tried to make love to you every day, but I could not succeed in doing so. Each day you gave a new excuse. Here is the list of the excuses that you had given from time to time. And there is a list of excuses that was given. I am watching my favorite show. I am on the phone to my sister. I am talking to my brother overseas. The window is open. The neighbor may watch. The light is on. The child is waking. I have to feed the baby. I just had the face pack. I have to dye my hair. I am busy with my makeup. I have headache. I am very sleepy. I have to go by the neighbor. I am going to a movie with my friend. I am going to a concert with my sister. I am going to the church for a special sermon. It's too late. 19. I have late night shower. 20. I have a late party. 21. I am drunk. 22. I am too tired to make love. I had an upsetting day in work. I have invited my friends from away for dinner. I am going for a cards game by the neighbor. I am talking to my friend. I am seeing my friend after almost 10 years. We have guests in the house. The door is open. It is too hot to make love. I am feeling too cold to undress. It is too early to make love. Everybody is waking still. I still have. And the last. And that is all you can think about making. I do sincerely hope that we can improve on this and continue to delve into one another through our marriage that is now on the rumble. Such is the story of each one of you. You may laugh or you may add more excuses, but this is the situation of each one of us. It is Mullah Nasruddin who wrote the letter. I have not come across the letter written by Mrs. Nasruddin to her husband Mullah, but the contents will be the same, because this is how the feminine mind thinks. Masculine mind thinks slightly different. So Mrs. Mullah Nasruddin's reply to her husband in celebration of 25th anniversary would be slightly different. I will go into more details of this aspect as we go on. But my understanding or the message is not to console you or promise you something of any hypothetical state. First, it will shake you and your roots, shock your mental structure, demolish your way of thinking, and then slowly and slowly give you a new foundation on which to build your life's structure, to build your understanding. For many lives, I had stumbled, groping in dark for the way out. Now that I have found, and this is what I am sharing with you. I am not imparting you any knowledge. These talks are not the treatise on sex and marriage. Instead, this is the understanding of a Buddha into life and its various aspects. When awareness dawns and flourishes in you, understanding comes. First, light comes. When light descends at the level of the mind, understanding comes, followed by actions. You are light unto yourself. I share my insights that are significant aspects of life. This is a preview. Sex is not a sin. Remember, repression is sin. Sex is very natural and utterly spontaneous. I go on repeating that it becomes part of your understanding. You have not done anything to have it. It is inborn and part of your being. Never condemn it, judge it, afraid of it, and never fight with it. Be aware of it, and that is all you can do. And in that awareness lies the seed of transcendence. Simply go into it more and more meditatively. Let it happen in such silence, in such deep acceptance, that you can know the very core of it. The moment you penetrate to the very core of sexual organs, you will find sex is losing its appeal for you. And then your energy will begin to move to a higher plane, because then the energy is unlocked and nullifies the gravitational pull of sex. As a shock, you are pulled into the realm beyond sex and dualities. As the energy moves to higher planes, you will become more loving and less sexual. You are embodiment of compassion, and the rest follows as its shadow. And this happens spontaneously. Those who are alone or do not have a companion, but have the experience somewhere or the other, they must have the reminiscent of the past experiences. And even those who are accompanied by their spouses must reminisce the past moments of bliss through this act. And when you go into that meditatively, you can do two ways. You can enter into the present act meditatively, or you go into those moments that have already happened meditatively. You are entering into it. A different kind of understanding begins to come into you. For instance, you are reading a book, and you have read the book once. And when you have read it once, you understand it at a particular level. When you have finished reading it once, your level of understanding changes. Then when you go and read it a second time, you get another set of insights into it, which are different than the first. Then you go and read it third time, you get even those points which you had missed in the first and the second instance. Same way, when you are entering into those moments that have already happened, and you are trying to understand those meditatively, you are going deeper and deeper. Insights becomes more and more intense, and out of that meditativeness, one day love and compassion is born into you. You have separated from your spouse because of anger or because of any other reason. You have not been able to forgive, then forgiveness is born into you. If marriage, if this male-female relation does not bring forgiveness in you and love in you, then it is not worth. But it always happens, the even before you enter into this male-female relation, if love is overflowing, and if there is, you have understood the deeper aspects of forgiveness, then the journey becomes very easy. And you can progress, you can come out of this male-female relation very quickly. And if it is not the case, then you have to feel, you have to allow forgiveness to be born in you. You have to learn to forgive. And when you become the embodiment of forgiveness, you will realize slowly and slowly you enter into another realm which is beyond the gravitational force of the earth, which is the force of Greece, and you are moving into a different direction.